Okay, yo, what is good, everyone? It is Monday, the start of my deload week. Funny thing is, so I live in the desert where it doesn't really rain. And last night, we were somewhat in the path of that one Hurricane Hillary. Its tail kind of went through our town. Usually doesn't get rain in this area, so I haven't left my neighborhood. So the minute I set out, I don't know how the roads are going to be. This desert wasn't really built for rain. So when it does rain and it does get a little bit of rain, it like causes traffic jams for a whole week. And yesterday was pretty heavy rain. So hopefully the gym is not closed because I'm trying to get a full body workout today. Like I said, it's a deload week. I'm not going hard on just one focused body part today. Going to go ahead and start off with some back. It's always good to start off with back. It'll pretty much pump you up and have your posture ready for every other movement. For example, like chest, your back is pumped. You're set to be just laying down and pressed with only your chest. Same thing with your shoulders. And I'm going to drink this Carilamine concoction just because I am brain dead. Just woke up and I need some caffeine. I don't know what flavors I mix together, but that ain't it. All right, guys, so catch you guys at the gym if it is open. If it's not, then I'm probably just going to post this and call it a day. See you in a bit. Cool, so the gym is open. Going to knock out this full body deload workout. Kill the rest of this not so good tasting concoction. I don't know what flavors I mix. It just didn't go well, but whatever. Flickering light gives me horror movie vibes.
But I'm pretty, like, a lot of the flashlight, a lot of the lights are doing that. All right, so basically because of this hurricane, no one showed up to the gym. We got the whole gym to ourselves. We're gonna start off with assisted pull-ups. Pretty much pump up that back, get us prepared for the rest of the full body, well not full body, but upper body movements. It's a deload week, so I'm not really going crazy on these workouts. I'm aiming to go for maybe 12 reps at 70% of my, you know, one rep max. And then, yeah, we're not going for more than like 3 sets either. So we're going pretty light. Just enough to get a pump, you know? Take a little bit of the resistance off. That seemed pretty easy. The music in here is pretty loud. I don't know if it's gonna pick up with the mic. I hope it doesn't. I'm not trying to copyright it anymore. This is what really sucks about being natural in the fitness industry. You look really small in clothes. I'm not saying that I don't look small without clothes. I probably look small compared to a lot of people in the industry. But I'm saying, I wouldn't think I have the body I have with the sweater I have on, you know? Okay. This one should be better. Yes, sir. Oof.
Oh.
I don't know what I just did there with my feet. Probably look awkward as fuck. Okay, next up we got some Smith machine work. I'm gonna do the incline press and then shoulder press on here. I'm just gonna switch out the fucking bench. I don't like this one. From experience, I believe it's right there. Let's put these keys away before I lose them. Shit, am I even recording? Yes, I am. Okay. 12 reps. Yeah, definitely gonna stick with the fucking plate on that. Holy shit. So the reasons I am taking a deload week is, one, you should definitely fucking program them into your workouts. After pushing your body continuously for like 4 or 5 weeks, definitely take a deload on the 5th or 6th week. As in, like, take a step back, don't lift as heavy. You will come back stronger the next week. And then it helps your body recover, as I'm doing right now. I'm doing a slow eccentric and an explosive press to really make it more effective since I'm not going heavy. Ooh, pretty good, pretty good. Dude, the humidity's crazy. That rain brought a shitload of humidity. And this gym ain't got its AC on. But it's cool, though. It's keeping me nice and warm. Making this workout a little bit more better. Slow down. Next up, we got some lateral raises. This is honestly one of my favorite machines for shoulders. If you could set it up properly, sometimes you're too low and you're shrugging the weight up, but if you set it properly to where it's all shoulder, dude, this shit feels amazing. We're just doing 3 sets of 20. Something light. Try to lead with that elbow. Good. What I like to say to best help you with the lateral raises is to imagine that you're a puppet on strings and then they're pulling you up through the elbow. You know, you're leading up with the elbow. Okay? The wrist and the hand just follow. You know, because it's attached to the same bone forearm. set. Good. Perfect. We'll do 3 sets of 15 on this as well. Set this up to me. Let's put that in number 4.
Please give me the number 4.
And we'll go to 85. Dude, who the fuck is like unscrewing these? Okay. That was light work, so let's go up a little bit. Too much of light work. Too little work, I must say. What I'm gonna do, because I do want to focus a little bit more higher, I'm gonna grab it higher up on this handles, kind of flex it up here. Finish off with some arms and call it a nice upper body day. Last set. Don't feel good. Okay. Let's go knock out some more back. Okay, so I'm gonna set up the camera in this angle because I'm gonna be supersetting these next two back movements. So it's gonna be a light superset, but just to get more blood into the back because I like a nice pumped back. Okay. First thing I'm gonna want is this weird looking V thing. I don't know what the name of the attachment is, but it kind of looks like a stick figure bird. If you know, you know, right? Let's get this higher up. the way I like to do straight arm pull downs is that I kind of flare my elbows out like this, and I kind of dig down almost as if I'm punching down, but I still keep the position of my arms locked. Only thing that's moving up and down are my shoulders. Like we're older. Good.
Okay, let's take a peek at what this. I mean, it wasn't bad of a workout. I had a decent workout. You went nothing but lightweight. Focus on mainly squeezing and the eccentric movements of the workouts. And I want my shoulder to recover. So, let's see this. Let's see a thing. I do got a confession to make. Saturday night, I had a cheat meal, pretty big one too. After work, I went over to Wingstop. Yeah, so Saturday night, I went onto the Wingstop website, and my go-to is their wing special that has 20 boneless wings and the fries. Damn, I'm a sucker for that. And well, I've been dieting for like 11 weeks now, so I was like, I'm craving that shit. Luckily, I didn't binge eat. It was just one meal. It was a hefty meal, though. I ain't gonna lie. This is what we're working with. After that cheat meal, what the fuck is it down there? That's a physique update after having a cheat meal. Saturday morning, I woke up at 197. This morning and yesterday morning, after that meal in me, holding onto some water definitely, I went up to 202. And visually, you can't really tell, but the scale was telling me that. So, I mean, maybe it's all in my gut. Maybe I just gotta take a shit. So yeah, let's go ahead and hit the road. Hopefully there aren't as many roads. Hope there aren't as many roads blocked because of the stupid hurricane.
Yeah.
I mean, if I'm being honest, it wasn't much of a hurricane here. We got clouds of the hurricane with some wind. But I wouldn't say it was a hurricane. Definitely need a haircut. I don't like all these curly hairs popping out of my hat. But I'm also broke and lazy. So, we gotta deal with that shit. Another successful day in the lab. Okay, so we got chest, shoulders, back, and arms complete. I forgot I did an upper body. I was about to just say I did chest, but I didn't. I did upper body, and it felt great. No one was here for the majority of the time, which felt even better. No one showed up because I guess everyone's streets were flooded in and they couldn't get out. Luckily, I didn't care. I was like, I gotta get the hell out of here. I gotta go to the gym. One thing I cannot live without is the gym. Ever since I started going to the gym, it's something that's been consistent in my life and I've not been able to drop it. Days that I don't go to the gym, I will admit I am depressed. I feel depressed. I hate it. I hate my life when I don't go to the gym. It might sound a little extreme, but it's just once you find joy and fulfillment from something, you want to keep pursuing it. Like, why drop it, you know? It's like if something makes you happy, you're like, I'm only gonna do that one time, or like, I'm only gonna do it once a week. Then it's like, you're not getting your daily dose of happiness, man. So first thing I do every single day is hit the gym. I feel good right after. But then like 4 hours from here, it's all downhill. Cause I am up since 4:30, it's already 6:30. Gotta go to work, start at 10. And then from there, halfway through my shift, I hate everyone. I'm like, I need the gym again. I'll be back tomorrow. And I don't know what the fuck that accent was. But yeah, basically, see you guys tomorrow. Tomorrow is the lower body day. Focusing mostly on quads. So it's gonna be a light lower body quad focused workout. See how that goes.